So I am on my Windows machine right now and I am using WSL to access our terminal. So I have configured the Vim here. Yeah, I have configured the Vim here as well, and as I'm using Ubuntu 18.04. I think, let's check. So okay, it's Ubuntu 18.04. I just had set it up. So here I am using a test file here, test cpp. Let me open it up using the vim command. So since this is on my main system, main operating system, let me first open up this node tree, and I can also open up this toggle tag bar toggle. We have got some functions. This is just a sample code, just a test code. We can go to some objects, jump out to them, and I can just toggle these things here. I can open up a file. Okay, I might be having a Python file. No, okay, I'm not. How am I not having a Python? Oh, that's cache. I might be having a Python file here. Okay, let's open it in a new tab like that. Yeah, I didn't have to set the mouse here, because this is Windows terminal. And so this is like that. I can open up the node tree again. I can open up the toggle bar. Maybe, yeah, there are many other definitions here, other things. So let me quit out of here. Let me close these stuffs. Let me show you the Vim RC. So these things are similar. I have set the cursor line, and you might have already noticed I'm using color scheme as jelly beans. Let me show you. So the color scheme right now is jelly beans, and I'm using the cursor line because the cursor line in jelly beans looks a little bit good. And since I'm using this on my main system, so I don't have to worry much about the resource consumption, that much about resource consumption. So this is my VimRC, just basic VimRC for that. And that's and is there anything else? No. Okay, so that was just an example how you can use the Vim thing, how you can configure Vim on the on WSL as well. So thank you for watching.